Hi y'all, it's Elizabeth, and I sat down to film a traveling or flying with an infant and breastfeeding all that stuff video, and then I accidentally deleted it. So I'm redoing it, and I have a couple things I guess that I'm going to add. So this video is going to be about traveling on an airplane with an infant for a long period of time, like 14-hour flight plus. And then also like a little flight too, I guess. But because I went from Japan to America last year to visit my family, and then from America to Japan back. And then when we PCS'd, which is permanent change of station, we did it again. So I just wanted to tell you what I learned, like what I did the first time, and then what I learned from the second time and all that stuff. So here we go. So I would definitely recommend when you're packing and traveling with a little baby. My son, I think, was 10 weeks old. Yes, he was 10 weeks old because we left like at the beginning of November because I was waiting for his passport. I would recommend getting a good diaper bag with like a backpack and a diaper bag. I have a Vera Bradley convertible bag. It converts into a backpack, and that way it's small and compact, and you can convert it into a backpack if you want, which is easy. Because I was told to wear the baby a lot, so that way you could have your diaper bag on your backpack and your baby on the front, and you're kind of like all good to go. So I got this diaper bag, and I'll put a link below of my video about it, like what's in it and all that stuff. And at the time, I was not cloth diapering. I was doing disposables, and even if you're on that long of a flight, I would recommend disposables anyways, because that's a lot of diapers to bring. I mean, that's almost like a whole 2 days of diapers to bring, and then you're going to have your wet bag, and it's just going to be a lot of stuff to carry, and I don't even think it would fit in all that, because the flight is 14 hours. So I brought a Ziploc bag, and I filled it with diapers and a little thing of wipes. That way, when I went to the restroom, all I could do was bring the diapers and the wipes with me. I wasn't bringing my whole entire diaper bag with me. But I did just want to have it just in case I had extra outfits. And going through the airport when I was changing flights, you know, I wanted to have it just to keep it safe. And I packed two pair of, like, footy pajamas, which I can show you kind of the kind that I brought, like, pajamas like these. Little funny pajamas, just so he could wear them and be comfortable, and they were like easy to change into. And back then he was like he spit up a lot, and so I wanted something that I can change him into if it got stinky. And I think I also had a onesie underneath here because it was really cold on the airplane. So I had him in this, and then I changed him when we got to America into like a fresher outfit. And then I think I changed him again once I landed at my final destination. So it was just something kind of easy and comfortable that he could change it, that I could change into. And then when I was booking my flight, I requested to have a bassinet. And then they put you like in the front row, I guess you can say it, where there's like nobody in front of you. And then there was a space where the bassinet latched on the first flight, and he didn't really sleep much on that plane because he was only 10 weeks old, and he was still kind of like crying it out and didn't really want to be held, didn't really want to be put down. So it was really hard to kind of work with him on that. And a lady helped me and held him, but the seatbelt sign was on, so like I couldn't get up and walk around, which kind of was awful. But he eventually kind of settled down. So speaking of settling down and stuff, I would recommend... What I did, was I didn't bring the boppy, which is what he nurses on all the time. So if he does nurse, if your child does nurse with the boppy, they will let you bring it on the airplane. The pediatrician told me to nurse on takeoff and landing, which is what I did. And I was really nervous, and I didn't have the boppy, and it was kind of like a whole bunch of mess, and I got a milk blister and all this crazy stuff. But, I did do that, and it really helped with the ears. They say, you know, to do that with the ears. And so we had the whole 14 hours. He finally settled down towards the end. And usually they said if they're in the bassinet and the seatbelt sign's on, you have to hold them. So that was kind of the stinky part about, I guess you could say, about having a bassinet, because You take him out. No one really said anything to me once he was asleep. I mean, of course, on takeoff and landing, they can't be in it. So once he was asleep and the seatbelt sign was on, they didn't necessarily say, like, oh, you need to take him out because he was asleep. And I think he was kind of bothering people. But, you know, take him to landing, I took him out. And then another thing that I brought was a carrier, a buckled structure carrier. I didn't have this one at the time, but... I have the Beko Gemini, which is in my son's room, and he's napping, so I can't get it out. But he was old enough, that one you don't need like an infant insert or anything, so he was, if you're traveling with like a really small baby, I would recommend that one. I was using a wrap type carrier at the time, and then I switched him over because he was just at the mark or whatever where he could be in that carrier, and that was kind of a savior. In Japan, you don't have to take them out of the carrier doing security, so that was nice. But when I got to the States, I was like, okay, you need to take him out. But it was still nice to be able to like carry him around and have to carry, I could put my luggage in the stroller and I can just carry him around, because I brought the stroller because I was going to be at my parents' house for a month. And it was definitely handy, and he can be in the carrier while we were sitting down because my arms would kind of get tired. It was nice to have a carrier. Definitely recommend one that you can use that's easy and to kind of get off and situate the Beko Gemini. You can like clip right here. I mean, this one's awesome. I'll have to do a carrier review. I would recommend kind of one like this because you could just throw the straps kind of over you or whatever. But it really works really, really well. I definitely recommend having a carrier because you're hands-free. So then when I got to my parents' house, I kind of sleep trained Emmett, and he was sleeping better, taking a pacifier, and so it was really nice. So the little planes, I think he fell asleep on the one, because I had a really early flight. So he fell asleep on the little plane. I just kept him in the carrier because it was super awesome to have. And he sucked on the pacifier for takeoff and landing, which was good, so I didn't have to nurse him. And then on the big flight, this time the bassinet was like on the floor, but he still couldn't be in it when the seatbelt sign was on, but it was much less turbulence. I walked him around more, and that kind of helped me out. I don't know why I didn't do it the first time. I guess I was really nervous, so I would definitely recommend walking your baby around, kind of just looking at people, especially if he's like crying, because you know they don't want to sit there for a very long time. So I just put him in the carrier, like walked him around, and he like smiled and got to see people, and then he finally went to sleep, and then he slept pretty much. I think he was up for 6 hours and then slept the rest of the time, so it was really, really nice that was doing, and I just nursed like I normally do, and we landed, and it was all good. So the second time, I guess the third time when we PCS from Japan to America, we flew from Japan to Seattle. We were on a military flight, and this time I brought my Boppy. And definitely wish I would have, like I said earlier, brought it, because they'll let you carry it. I know military flights are kind of different and stuff with the rules, but the regular, we went on commercial when we got to Seattle, Washington, and they let me take it. And this is actually perfect because they could lay on it. Like, I don't even think you need the bassinet, because he probably would have fell asleep on this when he was littler and just stayed asleep that way. But we PCS'd, he was almost 6 months, so I'm so happy I brought this thing this time. I didn't use a cover because I didn't care at that point. You know, when he's almost like 2.5 weeks old, I was all like, oh my God. And then now, but I just brought a really big t-shirt, extra large t-shirt that I wore when I was pregnant, flipped it up. That's all we had. I didn't care. He was next to me. And at the time, he would even like hang out and like look around, and my boob would be out, and I would just kind of cover it a little bit if he were to do that, because he was like all into doing that at the time. Like, let me look around, you know? So, definitely would recommend that. And nursing, I don't think I nursed on takeoff because he was taking the pacifier really well at that time. I don't even think I nursed it. Like, if he was asleep, his ears didn't really bother him on landing and takeoff. I think he would suck it out with a pacifier. But if your baby doesn't take a pacifier, definitely nurse on landing and takeoff. I would totally recommend that because it does really hurt their ears. So. And this also came in handy as a pillow for me and my husband when Emmett wasn't using it. Once again, I brought a carrier with me, and he slept on the flight We had a 9-hour flight and then a 5-hour flight, I think. It was a long, it was from Seattle, North Carolina, so he slept like two, I think it was 4 hours. He slept 2 hours in there, and then he woke up, kind of got hungry, so I fed him. I only had to nurse him like one time on that little flight, which was really nice because he was kind of weaning. He wasn't on solids yet, but he was kind of not nursing as much as he was before. So if you're going to travel with an infant, definitely recommend Boppy if you need it. Carrier for sure. Buckle carrier, that way it's not a wrap one where you're like trying to do all these cool stuff with it, something you just slap on, and like a backpack, diaper bag, or just a backpack in general, and then keep your diapers and wipes in a little bag so you can just run to this changing bathroom if you need changing, and of course bring a couple extra outfits, something that's comfortable and easy to change on too. So I hope this helps, and thanks for watching. Bye.